Thank you all for coming and joining me at my talk. I think scripting is rather popular, as I can see. So I will talk today about enhanced scripting facility and how you can make your life easier and more productive using Liferay scripting facility. But not only the basic Liferay scripting facility, but an enhanced scripting facility which we make use of in our projects. So about me, as Nadja said, I am Jens Bruhn. I'm a senior IT consultant and software architect at Prodyna AG. I'm with Prodyna since 2009, and at Prodyna I'm the lead of our solution center Portal Technology, which is an expert group dedicated to portal technology and portal projects. And my main project focus lies on international intranets. So who is Prodyna? Prodyna is a consulting corporation. We face rapid growth during the last years, and at the moment we have six offices all over Germany. We have one office in Basel in Switzerland, and we are in Serbia. At Prodyna I have about 239 colleagues. We are all permanent employees, and 15 of them are in back office. So here's a little tech loud about the topics we are dealing with. And well, I don't want to talk about Prodyna my whole talk. So if you have any questions, please meet us at our booth so we can provide you additional information, what we are doing, how we do it, and other aspects of our work. We are Liferay Platinum Partner, and we are the main sponsor of this conference. So enough about Prodyna, let's start with scripting. I will give you a few remarks on Liferay scripting. So one initial question: how many of you make use of Liferay scripting in their daily work? Okay, that are not so many. How many of you make use of workflows? So those that raised their hand before, you also make use of scripting because workflows make use of scripting too. So what is Liferay scripting? These points are taken from the user guide of Liferay 6.2, so you find it in the internet. And what you can do with Liferay is basically, depending on your configuration, access all services of Liferay. So scripting has huge power. You can run your scripts directly in the script console, which is a little bit hidden in the control panel. And additionally, scripts can be used and are used in the workflow engine. So for example, if you have a workflow for web content approval, these two lines which change the state of your web content, this is basically scripting. Yeah, well, and you can make use of custom tools within scripts too. So what can you do with the script console in the administration portlet inside control panel? Well, you can, for system administrators or other users with sufficient permissions, you can go there and execute your scripts to perform repetitive user maintenance operations, bulk manipulation, making use of the API, etc. So what you basically do in the control panel is you go to a 1 second. You go to the control panel, go to server administration, have script here, and you can choose your scripting language. You can say, well, I do it in Groovy, Python, etc., and then hit execute, and then you get the output of that script. That's all. So this is Liferay scripting, where the interface is not very complex, but what's behind it is rather mighty. So you can do everything. But what you can't do is these aspects we face in our projects, we were missing. So as you saw, you have this text area. You can copy and paste your scripts inside that area. hit execute, that's all. So no management of scripts. Then what you don't have, or what you must do, is manually execute. So what you saw in the remarks from the user guide of library, repetitive tasks, etc., this is not supported by the administration portlet. So you have to do it manually. Then the output, well, you saw this nice area, this paragraph where the output is displayed. If you want to do something with the output, you have to copy and paste it somewhere else. And there's no output processing besides this simple printing of outputs. So, and then as you don't, as you are forced to copy and paste your scripts inside the text area, there's no explicit permission handling on script level. You have the permissions to execute the script, but you don't have permissions on script level. So these were some requirements which we faced in our projects, and we wanted a solution for that. We want to have support for all of this. So what we did was we developed, we call our plugins with the prefix Nabucco, Nabucco Script Center, which is basically a Liferay plugin, which is on one hand integrated into Control Panel, and on the other hand, you can place your this plugin on portal pages. So this is the background. What you it is independent by means of we don't have any hooks of some JSPs or something like that, but this is completely self-contained. So you don't have any problems with patches, with other aspects of Liferay. It's completely independent. Besides making use of Liferay scripting engine. So we rely on Liferay scripting engine. In this context, we don't have any extensions of the script engine. So you can make use of Script Center only with basic Liferay, plain Liferay. Okay, so enough about the surrounding of Script Center. What does Script Center do? We have four main aspects. We have script handling, how scripts are managed and supported in Script Center. We have scheduling. So we wanted to have time-based execution of scripts. We have output processing. So what can we do with script output? For example, with reports, with some information about what happened during script execution, etc. And we have a permission system on script level to support execution of scripts by normal users if we want to. So first of all, what we have is Script Center supports the creation, manipulation, and inspection of scripts. So for these purposes, we make use of this open source JavaScript-based editor code mirror. If you're interested in the editor, you can visit the website. And we do not only provide the script source code only, but also some additional information like a title for the script to better find it later on. We have an abstract, which is displayed in overviews, and we have a description. Maybe some of your colleagues need additional information like how to use a script, what do I have to consider, how do I avoid breaking the whole system, and yeah, comparable to scripting console, we also have ad hoc execution. So what is, if it's, also in Control Panel, but also here we have some rather simple interface which allows you to update the script. So you can give a title, an abstract, a description, and the original script supported to the code mirror editor with syntax highlighting and line indention, etc. And we have the possibility to execute a script ad hoc. So this is not this is not the real power, but it's the interface for managing scripts. So then, now it gets more interesting. what we wanted to do is, we want to execute scripts in regular intervals, maybe every 24 hours, and therefore we have some interface to schedule script execution to give it in the start date and the interval when execution should be done, maybe each hour, each day, each month, etc. And this can do through going to your script and say, well, I want to schedule my script. You have also a schedule overview if a script is scheduled many times. And you say, I want to add a schedule. You say when it should be executed next time. Maybe it should only be executed once, or maybe every day, etc. And the next thing is, or if you have any questions, then there will be time for Q&A. Next thing is output processing. That's a rather rich feature, because what you can do is say, I want to be the output of the script, some print outprints displayed on the console. Okay, sysout, as inside log files to the document library. So you can say, I want to have the output provided, for example, inside document library at a certain site. And you can define this like saying, well, which document title, where, and what to do if we find an existing file, like adding files with a time stamp suffix or something like that. So if you have to, for example, a script for user deactivation according to certain criteria, then you can say, I want to have a time suffix, because then you have for each day a report about user deactivation if you implement that in your script. Same holds for web content output, or you have email. If you want to have your script output as report, for example, to administrators or to a email distribution list, then you say, well, I want to send it through email from to subject, and then the script output is sent through email to according to this data. Finally, we have web content. This is nearly the same as for document libraries. So if you want to create reports with your scripts and display them maybe on site pages or on the landing page of the portal, then say, well, I want to have a web content output. And then you take this web content and put it into a web content display portlet. And later on, depending on your configuration, this is updated each day. So for example, portal activity during the last 24 hours runs each night at midnight, and then you have each morning updated your portal activities for the last 24 hours. Okay, so permissions. Well, these are the permissions you already know from maybe each portlet. This is permissions on script level, so who is allowed to view a script, who is allowed to update or change the script, delete permissions, but we have some additional permissions like inspect. So someone who is allowed to view a script is only allowed to view the metadata, like name, abstract, description. The script sources should not be displayed to users who don't have the inspect permission. I don't recommend to put any password credentials, etc., into script source code, but if you have confidential information inside your script source code, then you can prevent any normal user from seeing that source code through setting inspect only to administrators. Next thing is execute. This is the ad hoc execution. So in combination, it would be possible to allow users to only view the script, like description, abstract, and execute the script if they need to do it, but don't inspect the script and don't schedule the script. So through this permission system, we can have very fine-grained control over who is allowed to do what in the context of a single script. Some scenarios, I mentioned them a few seconds before. First thing is administrative tasks. We have groups of tasks to perform through scripts. First thing is administration. This is the deactivation of inactive user accounts. So, this is not a rather complex task, but through Script Engine, you have all freedom to decide which accounts are considered, maybe based on groups, roles, site memberships, etc., which user accounts to consider during script deactivation, account deactivation, sorry. Reporting would be something like portal activities, how many new web contents, how many wikis, how many updates during the last 24 hours, how many new pages, how many user logins, etc. Could be also generated through a script and then put to a web content. And finally, notification. Send them to web content owners and say, well, within the next 14 days, this and this and this web content will be marked for review or will expire. So how to do this? Oh, sorry. How to do this? This is a rather simple script which validates last login date on user accounts, finds those which are in a certain time span or which outside a certain time span, like the last 30 days, and then set the status for those account to inactive. This would allow you to each night deactivate accounts which were not used in the portal. Additionally, you can store information, for example, in document library to get an overview of deactivated user accounts and or send it through email. Maybe add certain criteria upon which it should be decided which accounts to deactivate. So this is basically the script. With some documentation, and here, for example, exclude administrators from deactivation. It would not be a good idea to deactivate all your administrators, and have some certain other criteria. And as you can see, this is not 100 lines of script, and then you just have to schedule this. That's all. Maybe you can think about what you would have to do if you want to implement that as a plugin, for example, as a scheduled job, and all the processes which are behind that, like deployment, etc. You get an idea of how easy it would be to make use of scripting for such an application area. So then the second example, here you are completely free of what information you should consider as long as it is in the database. So number of active users in the portal during the last 24 hours, or new pages, new contents, comments, etc. How active is my portal? Maybe also on site level. So how active are my sites within my portal? Can do that by scripting. Analyze all assets, all relevant aspects of your portal, and then write this to a web content. Okay, maybe you might say, okay, I can do also can do this also by web contents, like having a template and requesting this information from database and cache this script. But what we have here is we freeze the information on the time on which we execute the script. So maybe if we consider these active users, then we take into account last login date. If there are a lot of users logging into your portal at the next morning, then this information is lost. But here we freeze this information and provide it as one content on script execution. A little bit more about reminding web content owners. As you saw before, we have this output processing, for example, through email. But as you have all the possibilities of Liferay, all the services, etc., you can also send emails directly from within your script. So you could also, for example, make use of mail service util and send an email to each affected author with an individual email and maybe summarize this email. So these are some basic samples for which we provide demo scripts. There are a lot of additional scenarios within these topic areas. So since we have implemented this plugin, we make heavily use of scripting. But well, with scripts, you have great power and you can directly implement new scripts in the portal front end and well, hit the execute button. Well, you can bring your portal down in milliseconds. So a few recommendations from our experiences. Documentation is important. Okay, this is nothing new for you, I think, but what we have done, we provided for our developers a certain schema of how to implement a script. Start with the configuration section at the beginning, because then you can see what I have to configure for my script for proper execution. Next is validate everything. So do not only validate if some fields are set, but also if they have valid values. For example, for if you have site ID or group IDs, if you have user IDs, role names, etc. All these things must be validated, and script execution must be aborted if this is not, if some validation fails. Then next thing is, what we do is we take a parameter explicitly for, or a variable for configured. And we only store scripts which are used for ad hoc execution with this parameter set to false. This means, and if the parameter is false, script execution is aborted. So we force our colleagues and ourselves to take a look at configuration and then set this to true if I'm absolutely sure what I'm doing. Then what we also do is simulation in a production mode. So this is implemented. We have only a variable which is set either to simulation or production. Simulation does nothing but print out what the script would do if it's in production. So we get an overview, especially in testing, what the script would do, but you have no manipulation of your portal and of the internal data sources. So this is also some some force your colleagues not to execute the script, just hitting it and that's all, but to set this to production and to be absolutely sure that this script is ready for production. Yeah, and if a script is productively used, for example, in schedules, you shouldn't change it. Just provide a new script because, if you don't know if a script is scheduled or you see that a script is scheduled and store it in an inconsistent state or it's work in progress or whatever, this could cause damage to your system. So productive scripts should be frozen. So I want to give a short outlook. Up to now, what do we have? We can manage scripts. We can assign permissions to scripts. We can edit our scripts in the front end. We can perform ad hoc execution of our scripts. We can schedule script execution. And we have our output processing alternatives. This was a good thing, but we missed one thing. And this is what we're currently developing, or what is nearly finished, event-based script execution. So we don't only want to execute a script all 24 hours, but for example, if a user account is manipulated, if a new page is created, if a new site is created, this is basically in the background, it is model listeners. So script execution in the context of model listeners. What we do here is, and this is only implemented at the moment for 6.1 because we have a concrete project where we need this. And what you do is nearly the same as for scheduling. You say, I want to intercept lifecycle events. I choose a target class like user, group, whatever. Say which events are relevant. You know this element from model listeners, I think. So like on before create, on after create, on before update, etc. And then configure your output the same way as for scheduling, if you want to. You can also no output processing at all. So this opens new possibilities for eher event-based scaling. For example, one easy example would be if you use a web content to provide your terms of use, then reset all agreements with terms of use for all user accounts if this content changes. So this is event-based. Yeah, you can do this through considering the corresponding portal property and yeah, execute the reset. Next thing would be category-based visibility of documents. So every time a new category is added to a document, and this category is relevant for permissions, then you can perform execute your script and set permissions on that document depending on your configuration. This is just two examples, which would not be possible based on a scheduled script execution. So as conclusion, through Nabucco Script Center, we have an extended script management functionality. Scheduling is supported. Script outputs can be further processed to any destination or certain number of output processors. You can set permissions on scripts. You can, for example, allow your users to execute scripts, but not to inspect them. Well, I showed you a few guidelines which we make use and which saved our heads a few times. And new feature, event-based script execution. Okay, so some in short, as you don't need any deployment processing like for your plugins, you are very much faster applying scripts. Then you don't have this plugin overhead, like you need to provide a plugin and implement nearly the same thing as in your script, but you only have to provide your own your core script logic. So you can focus on your fulfillment of your tasks, and you are flexible because you don't need a new deployment or something like that. You only have to change your scripts. And finally, we don't have any extensions of Liferay with that plugin. We are completely compatible with plain Liferay. So if you make use of the plugin, you stay compatible with Liferay. Thank you. Any questions?
Hello. I have a question about simulation. What happens when you use a Liferay API and you simulate this? Okay. How can you simulate
okay.
using this?
Simulation means we implement it on our own. We say we have this OSPLIT, we have our normal processing, and we have a branch around core API calls. So we implement it on ourselves. The script center does not identify if you do a manipulation operation, but you have to implement it in the script, and you say, if we are in simulation mode, don't do this way. So it's more a guideline of how developers for scripts should work, not a feature of Script Center, but only a recommendation of how you should implement your script.
Only a quick question about licensing. What is the licensing model for this plugin?
There is no licensing model at the moment, so come to our booth, we talk about it. And
do you have any script repository?
It's also the possibility for script imports implemented in the plugin. And we have at the moment these five basic scripts, but we are increasing the number of scripts which we provide. So Script Center already comes with I think two or three scripts which are directly installed, like this user deactivation or this statistics generation. So yeah, this is the idea behind that, not only to be in our project, just implement the scripts there and then keep them because it's our treasure. No, this is already considered during development of the plugin. It should be possible to exchange scripts and provide them as import. I wanted to ask about configuration. You are there is a like possibility to pass some parameters for the scripts, or is it just plain execution?
This is at the moment it's plain execution, but this is some next features which comes after event based. So it would be a good idea to have something like comparable to a properties file, which allows you to set and which is pre-configured, and then because this was the idea for example for scheduling, to say, well, I have this one script, this is with the portal statistics. If you want to have this for sites, well, you can make use of the same script, but provide some, take this site and this should be placed into the web content of This is the idea, as we have that in mind, but it's not yet implemented, but the concept there.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and so this is not like available on public. It's like in
not at the moment. It should be. The plan was to make it available now, but regarding this feature, we considered it as highly important and to double the space of application areas, and implementation is finished a few days before, so we are currently in testing, and this implies additional data structures. So we don't want it to, we didn't want to provide a plugin. A few days later, you have to upgrade, and there might rise some problems, and everybody is unhappy because but the features are there. So when we finish that QA quality assurance, then we want to provide it in marketplace.
Okay, yeah. So we can looking forward. We are looking forward to see it in the marketplace.
Maybe if you come to our booth, maybe we can talk about getting an earlier version if you want to test it. Or
okay, thank you.
Hello. You explained that you could add the portlet to a page also instead of using it in the control panel.
Yeah.
The scripts that you create inside that portlet, are they scoped within that portlet, or are they available throughout all the portlets?
Okay, now we get into details. This is plugin configuration.
Okay.
So what you can do is you set a parameter and say, well, scripts are global or with site scope. So if you set this parameter, you can say, well, due to security considerations, I don't want to allow my site administrators to create scripts, etc. So I set it to global, and only global administrators are allowed to. Other way around, if you set it to site scoped, site administrators would be able to provide scripts, and you can you only see those scripts which are related to that site. So you can configure that.
So I'm very sorry, but it should start the new conference. But if you like, you can contact Jens Brün also here. Yeah.
Meet me at Prodana booth.
At the booth, or just now. Thank you very much.